The other important substitution reaction of phenols is bromination. Now recall that for benzene, substitution of bromine happens when we add bromine as well as a halogen carrier catalyst such as FeBr3 at room temperature to benzene, affording bromobenzene. Again, we can guess that the favorable electrophilic substitution of phenols means that bromination will be much easier. Now and indeed, bromination of phenols will not require the catalyst at all. Simply adding aqueous bromine at room temperature to phenols form the trisubstituted product with HBr as a byproduct. Note again the polysubstitution. Three bromine atoms are easily substituted. The product 2,4,6-tribromophenol will form as a white precipitate. However, there is a difference when we add bromine in the inert solvent CCl4. Reacting phenol with Br2 and CCl4 forms the monobrominated product 2-bromophenol or 4-bromophenol instead of the tri-substituted product. Now, why would this happen? Water, unlike CCl4, is a polar solvent. Using water will polarize Br2 molecules, changing the electron density in bromine to form a partially positive end and a partially negative end. Now, this makes bromine a better electrophile. Another thing that we will have to consider is that using water will ionize phenol partially to form the phenoxide ion, as shown by the equilibrium reaction here. Now, the negative electron-rich phenoxide will make a better nucleophile than the neutral phenol itself. Better electrophiles and nucleophiles will mean that the reaction will take place more easily in water than in CCl4, resulting in polysubstitution. In summary, just like nitration, bromination in phenols is also more favorable.